Learn grammar without any effort. Welcome to your digital classroom. I'm Saji KV and you are watching my channel, The Eureka. Let's learn tense. Tense means time. A verb form that expresses the time of action is called a tense. There are four forms of verbs as we learned: present, past, past participle, and present participle. These are the forms of verbs. We need to talk about our past, we need to talk about our present, and we talk about our future. Therefore, we have three types of tenses: present, past, and future. And each of these tenses is divided into four parts, four forms. Present tense is divided into four forms: simple present tense, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous tense. In the same way, past, simple past, past continuous, past perfect, and past perfect continuous tense. And again, future, simple future, future continuous, future perfect, and future perfect continuous tense. Thus, we have 12 forms of tenses. In fact, tense is the most important lesson on English grammar. Tense is the foundation of English language. Therefore, learning of tenses is very imperative, very essential for you to learn further grammar. And therefore, I request you to watch this section till the end. I assure you, you will learn tenses without any effort, because correct understanding of tense is essential for learning grammar. Now, let's directly begin with simple present tense. The formulae of simple present tense is subject plus verb 1 plus object. And where do we use simple present tense? What is the use of simple present tense? We use simple present tense to express a universal truth. What does a universal truth mean? It is a general fact, a general truth that is same forever. For example, the sun rises in the east. Water freezes at 0 degrees Celsius. It is a universal truth. Oil floats on water is another universal truth. Now, you think of a universal truth so that you understand and learn the tense without any effort. Yes, cows eat grass. It's a universal truth. Cows ate grass in the past, cows eat grass in present, and cows will eat grass in future. Therefore, it is a universal truth. Blood is red. It's a universal truth. Let's learn the second important use of simple present tense: to express
a habitual action.
We use simple present tense to express a habitual action. What does a habitual action mean? It means daily action, routine that we do regularly. For example, we go to school every day. I get up at 6 o'clock in the morning. Now, you think of another habitual action that you practice at home. I brush my teeth daily. So here, you need to understand the difference between universal truth and habitual action. Universal truth is same everywhere, whereas habitual action is dependent on an individual. Whatever we do for a period of time regularly, that action is considered to be regular habitual action. So whenever we speak about habitual actions, we should use only simple present tense alone. Many use present continuous instead of simple present tense. For example, if I ask you, which class do you study? Majority of you may say that I am studying in 8th class. It's wrong. You should say, I study in 8th class. This is a habitual action. And universal truth, that is permanent everywhere. That does not change from place to place. It's same everywhere. So, two uses, remember you learn. To express a habitual action and to express a universal truth, we use simple present tense alone. When I gave you the formula of simple present tense, I wrote there subject plus verb 1 plus object. Remember, when subject is I or plural, then we use verb 1. But when subject is singular, like he, she, it, Mohan, we use singular form of the verb. How do you make the verb singular? By adding yes or es to the verb. He plays football. We added yes to the main verb because subject is singular. He is the subject and he is one, and therefore we added yes to the main verb. And then if subject is plural, we play football. We is plural subject. Therefore, we use the base form of the verb. And now, we shall learn present continuous tense. The formula of present continuous tense. Subject plus is or am or are plus verb 1 plus ing plus object. This is the structure of present continuous tense. When do we use present continuous tense? We use present continuous tense to express an action which is going on at the time of speaking what is going on now? You are watching my video. I am teaching you English grammar. So here, what is going on at the time of speaking? We use present continuous tense. Next one, we will learn present perfect tense. Present perfect. The word present perfect shows that action which is complete now. So here the structure formulae of present perfect tense. Subject plus has or have plus verb 3 plus object. So here we use third form of the verb. When do we use present perfect tense? We use present perfect tense to express a recent past action. A recent past action. Action which is completed a few minutes before. A recent past action. For example, he has just gone out. I have just completed my work. Second use, to express a past action, the time of which is not mentioned. To express a past action, the time of which is not mentioned. For example, I have gone to Delhi. When I say I have gone to Delhi, you understand this is a past action. But you do not know when I have gone to Delhi. For such sentences, we use present perfect tense alone. When we mention the time, we use past tense. If we do not mention the time, we should use present perfect tense alone. Next, the third use of present perfect tense. And this is the most important use of present perfect tense. To express an action which began in the past and continues up to the time of speaking. The action began in the past and it continues up to the time of speaking. I have lived in this house since 2015. So here, I began my action since 2015. And I stay in the same house since 2015. Action began in the past and continues up to the time of speaking. He has worked for 2 hours. Here, the action began in the past and continues up to the time for 2 hours. Since and for we use in present perfect tense as well as in present perfect continuous tense. Since is used to express a point of time since 2015, since yesterday, since last year. For is used for expressing for a period of time, for 2 hours, for years,
for months and so on.
Let's learn present perfect continuous tense. Here, the use of present perfect tense and present perfect continuous tense is almost the same in the last use. Let us learn present perfect continuous tense. The formula of present perfect continuous tense is this: subject plus has or have plus been plus verb 1 plus ing. We use present perfect continuous to express an action which began in the past and continues up to the time of speaking. So here also we find action began in the past and continues up to the time of speaking. In fact, the last use which I mentioned for present perfect and present perfect continuous tense is same. When we use present perfect continuous tense, it indicates the action can be continued even after this time. For example, they have been studying here since 2015. They have been studying here since 2015. That is to say, their action began in 2015 and continues up to the time of speaking. It can continue even after the present time. And here also we use since and for. Simple present tense we use to express a universal truth and habitual action. And in present continuous tense, to express an action which is going on at the time of speaking. And now coming to present perfect tense, to express a recent past action. Second use, to express a past action, the time of which is not mentioned. Third use, to express an action which began in the past and continues up to the time of speaking. In present perfect continuous tense, the same use, to express an action which began in the past and continues up to the time of speaking. So, we learned present tense very well. I hope you understood the present tense. And therefore, as a homework, I request you to make one each sentence of each use of tense and write it in the comment section. We will pick out best 5 comments from the comment section and publish it in the next video. Remember, I gave last time a homework for you to do, and many students responded to the homework, and I pick out Tech Waris, who wrote the highest number of correct forms of the verb, and the verb begins with the first letter of his name, and I specially congratulate him for his effort, and I understand that he understood the lesson very well. I also appreciate those students who wrote their comments in the comment section of my videos. I hope you liked this video very much. If you like it, subscribe, like, and share.
Stay tuned for more videos on grammar and wait for the next video tomorrow.